Hello, I'm Steve with Danfoss Technical Support, and today I'd like to talk to you about R-22 refrigerant retrofits. R-22 is widely used in the HVACR industry. However, as this refrigerant is an ozone-depleting substance, it is being phased out in accordance with the Montreal Protocol. In the USA, the Environmental Protection Agency has established allocation levels for R-22 from 2015 through 2020. Each year, the amount of R-22 available to the market will be reduced until 2020, when production and importation of R-22 for the servicing of ACR equipment will cease. It is important to note, though, that this is not a use ban. Existing supplies of R-22, both virgin and reclaimed, can still be used to service systems after 2020, though future availability may become an issue. As the supply of R-22 tightens, many in our industry will consider refrigerant retrofits. While retrofits are often viable service options, it is important to familiarize yourself with the key issues surrounding these products, as none of them are drop-ins. The use of any retrofit refrigerant requires system modifications and produces changes in operating characteristics. Additionally, system capacities and efficiencies will often be reduced as a result of the refrigerant changeout. It's also important to recognize that not all R-22 units are credible retrofit candidates. Installations with flooded evaporators, for example, can be particularly challenging. As such, careful consideration should also be given to other service options. In some cases, replacing your equipment may make the most sense. The first major retrofit issue that I'd like to discuss is the suitability and safety of alternative refrigerants and oils. There are many products on the market today that are advertised as R-22 refrigerant retrofits. However, it's critical to ensure that you're using industry-recognized products that have been SNAP approved by the EPA for your application. A list of approved refrigerants can be found on the EPA's website, as well as safety warnings regarding the use of flammable or unapproved refrigerant retrofits. You should also familiarize yourself with the potential hazards of the refrigerants and oils that you'll be working with by reviewing their material safety data sheets. Always be sure to use personal protective equipment. Now, it's important to understand the types of refrigerants you'll be working with. R-22 retrofits are non-ozone depleting HFC-based refrigerants. These products are mostly immiscible with the mineral oil or alkylbenzene lubricants typically found in most R-22 systems. While some systems may perform acceptably using the original compressor lubricant, the use of immiscible refrigerant oil combinations may lead to problems with oil return and/or oil logging in many applications, such as systems with receivers or process chillers subject to low flow rates. This could potentially lead to compressor failure or reduced system performance. Therefore, monitoring of compressor oil levels and circulation rates is critical. Using POE or PVE oils of the proper viscosity ensures good miscibility with the HFC refrigerants, eliminating many of these concerns. Danfoss strongly recommends the use of POE or PVE lubricants with the HFC-based R-22 retrofit refrigerants. As these oils are hygroscopic and POEs have known solvency effects, care should be taken when handling these oils and performing oil flushes. System elastomers, like O-rings, will also be affected by the change of refrigerant in oil. Refrigerant permeates into elastomers, causing them to swell and helping them to form a seal. Degassing of these seals during recovery and evacuation, coupled with the use of new refrigerants that do not swell the elastomers the same as R-22, could potentially result in retrofit-induced system leaks. Therefore, it's always a good idea to repair existing leaks and replace elastomers, such as solenoid valve O-rings and Schrader valve caps and cores, as part of the initial retrofit process. And always leak check the system after a retrofit has been performed. Another important difference of note is that while R-22 is a single component refrigerant, R-22 retrofits or refrigerant blends that require special handling. First, all blends or refrigerants with a 400 or 500 series ASHRAE designation should be removed from the cylinder as a liquid. This helps to prevent fractionation or unwanted shifts in blend composition. Many R-22 retrofits are also considered high glide blends or blends that are susceptible to fractionation and as such may not be suitable for use in systems with flooded evaporators. Blends also have different pressures, namely bubble point and dew point, that are used during the servicing and optimizing refrigerant systems, such as when measuring or setting superheat and subcooling. Service personnel should familiarize themselves with refrigerant blend behaviors before working with R-22 retrofits. Many R-22 retrofits require noticeably higher flow rates than R-22 to produce similar system capacity. With some retrofit products, it may be necessary to replace expansion valves, orifices, distributor nozzles, or other system components. With other products, adjustment of the expansion valves may be all that's required. The use of R-22 retrofit refrigerants will also produce changes in operating pressures and temperatures. All of the mainstream retrofit options produce lower compressor discharge temperatures, which may reduce the need for temperature reducing technologies such as liquid injection. Many of the retrofits will also produce noticeably higher discharge pressures as R-22, and as such may not be suitable for use in most R-22 air conditioning applications. Pressure and temperature controls may need to be adjusted, or in some cases replaced, to accommodate the refrigerant system's new operating characteristics. Finally, the use of best working practices, such as proper evacuation and replacement of filter dryers, can help to ensure the success of your retrofits. A wealth of information has been developed on the topic of R-22 retrofits and is available. Service personnel should review retrofit recommendations and procedures from refrigerant, compressor, and system manufacturers before converting systems. Baseline data should also be gathered on systems running with R-22 when possible before starting a refrigerant changeover. This can help to identify system deficiencies and required maintenance or repairs, as well as provide a valuable reference for expected retrofit results. If you have questions regarding the material covered here or R-22 retrofits in general, please contact Danfoss Technical Support. Thank you and have a great day.